I just realized, because I was walking to your sister.
Oh, for real?
I was.
I look far younger. That's how you tell us apart.
How are you?
All right, for you.
Joining us on this afternoon. If you want an America that we can believe in again, an America that we can trust again, an America that works for all of us again, then you can't even spell America without Erica. I am Erica for us. Join us on the campaign trail. Good afternoon to you, Durham, and we'll see you the next time we come around. Have a wonderful day, everybody.
Had to come see Cameron Indoor Stadium at Duke. I can't come to Chapel Hill, Durham, and not come to Duke, huh? All I can think of right now is, too bad they can't win no damn football game. I guess basketball pay for football, huh? Shot fired. I know we support HBCU, so we had to come stop at NCCU.
I just want to say you're doing a phenomenal job.
Thank
I'm originally from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Okay.
I've been here 21 years,
okay.
But you make us proud.
Thank you, my sister. Thank you.
Okay.
Pleasure to meet
are
you.
Are you here for us?
I'm here to support Erica Smith. She's running for U.S. Senate here, so please give her your vote when you are voting the primary in the spring.
Okay.
So I'll be back, though, more to try to help your sister get elected.
Okay. All right.
Good to
I
meet you.
Support. Nice to meet you, too. What's
up?
Okay. What's up, people?
I see you before, man. How you doing?
Good, man. How are you?
See your Instagram. Brother,
so. See, appreciate y'all, man.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good day. Vote for Erica Smith, all right?
Erica Smith, for sure.
And looking at the diversity in this community, but understanding that all of our issues are related. Just like the healthcare crisis is related to the racial justice crisis, is related to the climate crisis, is related to the income inequality crisis, we know that for marginalized communities all over this world, we are connected. Our struggles are connected. So when we're talking about what's going on with the crimes against humanity, talking about George Floyd coming up on the year anniversary of that, Andrew Brown in Elizabeth City, we understand that the crimes against humanity here are the same crimes in Palestine, where we have issues with occupied, tell me the name again, Kashmir, and occupied Kashmir, and understanding how we need to come together, black, white, and brown, and start standing together on these issues, promoting economic equality, economic independence, promoting clean energy, clean air, clean water, making sure that healthcare is a basic human right. Everybody has a right to healthcare. Just Google Gary Chambers Jr. and it will all come up. He shut down a local elected official who was not doing her job. Instead of listening to concerned constituents and having conversations like we are now, she was shopping while they were talking about some racial discrimination on changing the name of a building. And so that's how he caught fire. That's how I learned of him. But I've watched how hard he has worked for communities, for everybody in the community. Doesn't matter what color you are, doesn't matter who you are. Gary Chambers has been in these streets and in the trenches fighting for all of us so that we can all have access to the American dream. And so he is a special guest, and I would love for him to share.
Well, thank you, Erica, and thank y'all for taking the time to listen today. You didn't come here to talk politics, I'm sure. But it says that you care about your community, that you took the time to do so. I've had a great opportunity to go around North Carolina with Erica the last few days, and I'm really learning and listening, you know, because when you come into different communities, everybody approaches their issues differently, even though we're dealing with the same things. I live in Baton Rouge in Louisiana, and our state ranks number 50 in the nation. We rank number 45 in healthcare, number 48 in education, number 50 in environmental quality, number 50 in crime, number 50 in opportunity. And so as bad as you might think you have it, we got it worse. And I ran for Congress earlier this year and lost by 1,500 votes. We raised over $500,000 from 15,000 donors from all over the country. But the progressive movement kind of sat on the sidelines and didn't help us. And so after our election, I could have went on vacation. I could have, you know, licked my wounds and cried about it. Or I figured that I could start helping other people early. But Erica is someone who I believe in, and I believe that she cares about people. And for someone in Louisiana, why do I come 700 miles to North Carolina? Because if Erica's in the U.S. Senate, that helps people in Louisiana too. That helps people in Alabama and Mississippi and Georgia. Raphael Warnock and John Ossoff winning in Georgia is helping us in the U.S. Senate, right? And so the larger the margin we have in the Senate, the better it is for the people of this country. 11 black people in the history of this nation have served in the United States Senate, right? There are 46 million African-American people in this country right now. And in the history of this country, only 11 have served. And currently, there is not a single black woman in the United States Senate, because Vice President Kamala Harris was the black woman U.S. Senator in the U.S. Senate, right? And if this is a representative democracy, right, then our country and our government should be represented by people who look like us, who come from the communities we come from, who have the understanding that we have, so that they can legislate with our humanity as a part of those conversations. And so Erica's gonna need help. She's gonna need people who can host conversations for her. She's gonna need people who can knock doors and make phone calls, because elections are hard work. I know that. I'm telling you, we had a staff of 17 people for a 10 parish congressional race. This is 100 counties in an entire state that this black woman is about to take on this effort. And she ran last year and came in second in the Democratic primary. Hundreds of thousands of North Carolinians voted for her. And so there's an opportunity for us to get a strike at it again and send the right person to the U.S. Senate. And so I'm here. And if I could come 770 miles to talk politics with y'all, surely you could go a couple blocks in your neighborhood and talk to your neighbors and say, hey, you know, there's a lady running for U.S. Senate. The election's in March of next year, but maybe we should tell a few friends about her. Maybe we should hold a backyard conversation, a barbecue, a cookout, and contact the folks with the team. Everybody throw your hands up if you're a part of Erica's team. Right. Throw your hands up high so they can see you. And these people are here for you to get the opportunity to connect to the campaign. Donations, I raised $500,000, all right? And if I had raised either another $100,000 or had another week left, we would have been in the runoff, because we needed about 753 votes in order to break the other way, right? Don't let this sister not have the resources she needs if you really believe that North Carolina needs a Democrat to go to the U.S. Senate to represent us, but not just a Democrat, but somebody who cares about people. At the end of the day, the government is supposed to be representing us and our values. That's your money down there.
So anybody talking about that's government spending, that's your dollars because you pay taxes.
Right, right.
And anybody who tells you that they're not going to vote, ask them, do you stop paying taxes? No. Every time you go to the store, you're paying taxes. And so to not vote or not be a part of the process is to let somebody else determine how your money gets spent and what the values of our government are. And so I appreciate you for giving me the opportunity and the space to be here. I'm really learning more. I'm going to be back, and we're going to bring some friends with us when we come again because we want to drum up some noise and support for this sister early. There are going to be other people in the race. That's how this thing goes. Everybody's got a right to run. But the real deal is she ran the last time. She's proven that she cares about people. And that's the voice that I'm going to support. And I hope that you support it as well and activate the people in your communities to do so.